Breedlove is lined up and just about ready to send this one off as we're ready to get this game underway.
Sends it sailing downfield. And they can forget about returning this one.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive.
And he's tackled at the 27.
Second and eight coming up here.
Ball on their own 27. He gets rid of this one. Defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. That could have been a big play for the defense.
Yeah, even though he had a good shot at picking it off, it's still a heck of a play to force the incomplete pass.
Dion awaits the snap. Mangum takes it at the 33, and down he goes at the 43-yard line.
The Cougars and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
From the 44-yard line, first down. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Everybody was fooled on that one.
Hey, that was a good job here by the quarterback. That could have play fake as a real weapon against an aggressive defense like this.
The 31.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
From the 31-yard line, second down.
He scrambled.
Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. So the scramble goes for 9 yards.
To the 11.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
Runs it left for a decent game. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Incomplete. He overthrew the intended receiver.
Oh, boy. They take a shot here at the end zone, and he just let that one get away from him.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. And it looks like they're going to bring everyone in tight for this one.
Touchdown.
PAT. So an 8-play, 57-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. The score now, 7-0.
Looks like they're ready for the kick.
He really got a hold of that kick.
And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
The Cougars are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change the game plan.
Caught out of the open. He's taken down at the 41-yard line. Their own 41-yard line. It's first down. He's at midfield.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
His way to the 33-yard line.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated at the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's the third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
He's at the 20. Tackle at the 9.
He gets another set of downs, and more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
Touchdown away from a tie. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That brings him second and goal.
Two times.
And it pays off. Touchdown.
Things can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. From his own goal line, he's to the 20, brought down at the 23.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency.
Taken down
right around the 24-yard line. Second down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on the 24.
And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look.
He's out of bounds at the 27-yard line.
Sacked for a loss.
White is back deep to return the punt. It's away, and it's a booming punt.
Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing.
And they make the stop
around the 21-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
It's second and 9.
Ball on the 21.
Easy.
complete, and he stopped immediately. We've played one quarter. We're even at seven in this one. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Throw to the tight end. He's pushed out of bounds at the 35. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty.
Offense.
They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
It's third down and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he hits him hard at the 35-yard line. From their own 35-yard line. First down. Of about two.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. Loss of three.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Quick out to his receiver. Brought down around the 42-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42. He's tackled at the 39. And this play is number 8 on the drive. At the 30, he's at the 20, the 10, and down he goes at the 4-yard line. This is the 9th play of this drive. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A nice 9-play, 71-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
They line up to kick this one away. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. to his tight end. They'll bring him down around the 34-yard line. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Feeds it to the back. Nice run there. Decent gain there on the play by the running back, and that's enough for the first.
Solid five-yard pickup. He was almost able to get to the secondary, but as it is, he still manages to move the sticks.
He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. And they hit him in the backfield. They come out on an empty backfield. First down, and they push him out at the 46. From the 46-yard line, first down. Open field. He's at the 30, and he's shoved out of bounds around the 25-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25. He's going to try and scramble. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Here's the eighth play of the series. And the safety with the interception. It's the safety who's in the right place at the right time.
The quarterback has to know where the safety is when he makes this kind of throw. Right here, he just tried to force something that wasn't there.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. Get to that quickly. The Golden Eagles will use their first time out of the half. The Cougars lost a player to an earlier injury, and unfortunately, it doesn't look like he's going to be able to come back today. Calls it in past the marker. Fires quickly, and he's got his man, and he's tackled at the 45. From the 45-yard line, it's first down. He's scrambling. Tackle made at the 43-yard line. Golden Eagles call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Quick throw. Excellent open field tackle.
Impressive gain there by the do-it-all back.
Got it and brought down immediately. He's on the run. Runs with it, and he's got room. He's taken down right around the 12-yard line. looking for his man, incomplete.
This is a well-designed play by the offensive coordinator. Everything really seemed to be working just fine, except for the quarterback. He's got to throw a better football.
From the 12-yard line, it's second down. Nice run up the middle. Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
And if they can connect on this one, that'll put them up by a couple of scores. Kicks away, and he's got it. Christian has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. An interception cut this offense last drive short, so I think they're going to be looking for a little more success right here.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
And he's tackled in the open field. So we've played two quarters. The Golden Eagles lead 17-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
The halftime lead is not insurmountable for this squad. You know, there are a lot of times when you watch the first half of the game and you start talking about mental toughness and energy and effort and all of those types of things. You get the sense this is more of an X and O deal for the coaches. A couple of minor adjustments that could really change the game in the second half.
Yeah, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. But if it's broke, it needs to be fixed. And there's some things that you definitely see offensive and defensively that these teams need to be sharper. They need to be crisper. They need to find an edge. Maybe they need to go more up-tempo. Maybe they need to pass the football a little bit more. Defensively, maybe you need to be a little bit more aggressive. This is one of those things where coaches have to feel out. They have a feeling out process. They have to feel what you do well, what you're not doing well. Sometimes you need to completely go in a different direction. You're down two scores. Something good has to happen. You need to change what you've been doing because it hasn't worked.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Golden Eagles continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He's got the corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 42.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
First and 10. Ball on their own 42. He's at midfield. Tackle at about the 49. Got an opening. Makes it out to about the 39. So he keeps it and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
From the 39-yard line. First down. Scrambling around. That's a great tackle at the 37-yard line.
Gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. And he's taken down at the 29.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. At the 20. He gets hit out of bounds around the 16-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. Nice play to set up first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
It's the ninth play of the drive. A short yardage defense here. And they'll score. Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. And he tacks on the extra point. A nine-play, 77-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Tailback, and he's met in the backfield. From their own 25-yard line, second down. And they make the stop at about the 33-yard line. Knock him down for a loss.
He's really quick with his lateral movement, especially for a guy this big. He got to the ball carrier before he could get out of the backfield.
Mangum is back awaiting the punt. Signals for a fair catch. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss. From their own 31-yard line, second down. Scrambling, and he's going to be sacked. Just an excellent individual effort to make the play there.
I have to tell you, for being so young, he looks pretty good out there, linebacker.
Flips it middle to the running back. Shakes off a tackle. They couldn't get anything to work, and it will be fourth down.
You always like to move the ball at least past midfield, if only to win the field position battle. The defense wasn't going to give them anything on that drive.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Booming kick.
gets out to about the 38-yard line.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Complete pass and hit hard as he came down with it. Their own 40-yard line. Second down. He scrambled. And down he goes. Right around the 42-yard line.
That's good for 2 yards. That'll bring up 36.
Throws it in a hurry. So close, but they fall short of the first down.
You've got to throw the ball a little deeper next time. Don't take any chances of coming up short.
That's three down and one to go. Golden Eagles with a three-point lead. Great three quarters of action. Tight ball game. And now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it.
Dion to punt.
Oh, excellent punt.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Tight ball game, one possession, but they've got an opportunity not only to score and take the lead, but get the momentum going on their side. They go with a run, and he brought down in the backfield. Second down and 14. Ball on the 16. And that one's incomplete. They come out in a five-wide set. Caught over the middle.
Here's the true test of a quarterback at any level. Can they make a good throw under pressure when one or two or three guys are coming right at him? I think this young passer has proven that, yes, he can.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 31. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they push him out at the 44-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 44.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 44-yard line, it's second down.
Now he tries to buy some time. He's tackled at the 43.
Thorne off the left side. Brought down at the 42-yard line. From the 42-yard line, it's second down. Fires it out, and he hits him hard at the 38-yard line.
That'll bring up third and four.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Just under three to go in regulation.
He goes out of bounds.
Right around the 38-yard line.
That'll bring up fourth and five.
It's up. No good. He missed it to the right.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Over the middle to his tailback. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
From their own 37-yard line, second down.
He's scrambling, and they got it.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
So the sack makes this third and very low. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Another sack.
Well, just a great series for the defense to force the three and out and get that kind of pressure on the quarterback.
Mangum awaiting the return. He really got a hold of that one. Gets to about the 41-yard line.
McLaughlin's mindset right now at this stage in the game has got to know that the defense is going to be attacking him.
Well, the defense is probably going to have two different defenders on him to stop him from making that big play for this offense. It's important that he and the quarterback are on the same page to be able to give them a chance to get some big yards and maybe eventually get them the winning score.
Just under two to go in the game.
They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. The spike will stop the clock.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 49. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers.
You can see the elation on the defensive coordinator's side of things, and why not? His defense just came up with one of the biggest stops of the game in a vital spot in this fourth quarter.
Wow, what a battle, and what a stop right there. Congratulations to that defense. That's going to be the ball game.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? The Cougars, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout. From the 49-yard line, second down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Looking for the corner. He's at the 30. Makes it to the 27. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
McLaughlin's impact on today's game, Kirk, we are expecting it to be on the positive side. Unfortunately for them, it ended up being a negative.
Yeah, definitely a tough loss to swallow. Typically, you'd like to see some other players step up and kind of help the cause when your great star player doesn't have an outstanding game. But in this case, I don't know if it would have made much of a difference.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.